Before we get too deep into this DVD, I want to just talk to you for a moment. Imagine for a moment it's about 2,000 or 3,000 years ago, and we're standing outside on a comfortable sunny day. And I ask you a question. What time is it? Well, you don't have on a Seiko wristwatch, do you? What would you do? Be honest with yourself. As you are sitting there watching this DVD on your television or computer screen, what direction is your video screen facing? North, south, east, or west? Do you even care? You have probably been watching this screen here for years, and the thought probably has never crossed your mind. So in a sense, an aspect of your conscious mind has been removed from the natural world. So what time is it? Now you're starting to think, okay, how do I tell time if I don't have a watch or a clock to look at? Well, I have to look at the sun and its position in the sky. I have to know where east and west is and estimate the time. To make a long story short, let's just say that the sun is directly over our head, which would mean it would be around 12 noon. Sometimes we have to start thinking outside the box or just thinking for ourselves. The sun is the closest star to us by which we calculate time here on Earth. The sun is a clock. Well, there are other stars, in fact billions of them. What kind of time are they keeping? What is their relevance to us as far as time, the time that they are keeping? Have you ever thought about these things? I would like to share something with you. I was talking to one of my physics professors one day, and I really got after him one day with questions concerning the derivation of the calculation of the speed of light and the permeability and permittivity of free space. He looked at me and smiled and said, "Kevin, we teach you what to think, not how to think." And I really hope I'm able by the end of this DVD to get you to start thinking along new lines. One last thing on the subject of time. You have been hearing a lot lately about global warming and the melting polar caps. We have been told by politicians and others that it is greenhouse gases causing the polar ice to melt. The polar ice caps have been there for thousands of years, and now they are melting. Let us assume for a moment that what we have been told concerning greenhouse gases are not the true cause of the polar caps melting. Let's take that walk back outside again. Hast thou entered into the treasures of the snow, or hast thou seen the treasures of the hail, which I have reserved against the time of trouble, against the day of battle and war? So what time is it? The word reserve means to retain or hold over to a future time or place. So where is God's treasures of snow and ice? Let us proceed with logic. No one will argue that the North and South Poles are treasures of snow and ice. And up until recent times, even in your and my lifetime, the snow and ice were locked up like a treasure box, or in other words, it was not melting. When water is locked up, it is frozen, and we call it ice. So what time is it? What clock are you looking at?